Thank you, sir. Good evening, one and all. So it's my proud privilege to stand here and present India's one of the largest COVID diabetic study. At the outset, I would like to thank organizers and Dr. Maheshwari sir, who is also one of the major contributors for this study, for giving this opportunity to present it in this prestigious conference. So to begin with, I would like to acknowledge Medeva, who is a scientific and knowledge partner for this study. And they have really worked hard to collect, implement, and analyze the data. So as it happened everywhere, India was also hit hard by the COVID pandemic. And we all faced almost more than 3.5 crores of these cases with more than 4.74 lakhs of deaths. We all observed everywhere that diabetes is one of the most important risk factor for serious illness and also mortality during this pandemic. And it was observed that there is bi-directional relationship between COVID-19 and diabetes. And probably what cases of diabetes we faced during these hospitalized cases, that few of them, they were diabetics previously. Few of them, they were unaware of their hyperglycemia because probably they were never investigated before. This diabetes or hyperglycemia is likely to be corticosteroid induced, which was one of the major treatment modality. And COVID causing pancreatic B-cell destruction, or it can be just like any other post-viral infection associated diabetes. So on review of literature, there is an increased frequency of diabetes onset and diabetes complications, which has been reported across the globe. And COVID-19 may elevate the risk of hyperglycemia and other complications in patients with or without prior history of diabetes. But it is still unclear whether this virus is inducing type 1 or type 2 diabetes, or it is causing some novel type of a typical form of diabetes. We also found that all these cases who were known diabetics or who had diabetes in pre-COVID state, they were presenting with more diabetic ketoacidosis, and that was associated with more morbidity and mortality. So considering the dearth of evidence regarding new onset of diabetes in COVID patients in India, the thought had come to the mind of Dr. Anuj Maheshwari, and he plotted the study he developed it with assistance of Medeva. And it became a multicentric pan-India study where almost 25 centers participated across India. With the aims and objectives to find out the impact of COVID-19 on blood sugar levels in recovered patients, because all those death patients were not studied. Only those who are recovered having diabetes and non-diabetics, they were participated, assessing as incidence of new diabetics and establishing a cross correlation with severity of the disease, clinical management protocol, medications, and demographics. So a study protocol and a study pro forma was formulated after a lot of brainstorming. And on this, almost 2,258 cases were enrolled all over India. After exclusion, age and all, for today's presentation, data of 1,664 cases was analyzed, whose data was complete in the registry. So following definitions were used for enrolling these cases, like those patients who were diabetic pre-COVID, who had mentioned as an existing medical condition before COVID. Non-diabetics were defined as patients with diabetes not being mentioned as an existing medical condition before COVID. and they were further classified as new diabetics who remained hyperglycemic and are being treated currently for diabetes, and non-diabetics who did not have diabetes on admission and they remained non-diabetic they remained normoglycemic even on discharge. So one thing we need to note here is that all values presented in this document are crude estimates and have not been adjusted for age or gender or any other. So the average age of sample is around 50 years and the minimum age is 19 years and maximum 95 years. And if we see that male preponderance everywhere in this study also, we had maximum male population. 58% of patients are diabetic in the study population who had diabetes in pre-COVID state. 78% had at least one pre-existing condition and 42% patients had two or more pre-existing comorbidities. So the diabetics and non-diabetics, we tried to analyze this data considering all different parameters, and we found that diabetics are slightly older than non-diabetics and they had more comorbidities. Over half of these non-diabetics, they do not have any other comorbidity, and this difference is statistically significant. So comorbidity definitely was more with diabetic patients. Now coming to other parameters like hospitalization, requirement of oxygen, and different modalities of treatment, significantly more proportion of non-diabetic patients, that is 63%, have been hospitalized for COVID care when compared with diabetic patients who were 45%. Percentage of severe disease, which was found on HRCT, was more, and more proportion of non-diabetic patients, that is 54%, were also required oxygen support. So when they were compared with diabetics. So uses of medication for treatment of COVID is similar across both the groups. So as being this study is of recovered patients, so probably that is the reason why comorbidities were more in non-COVID patients and they were more hospitalized, because the mortality was high in diabetic patients. So average highest blood sugar level during COVID and among diabetic patients is almost twice that of non-diabetic patients, and the difference is statistically significant. And the average number of symptoms among diabetic is significantly more than non-diabetics. So there is a significant drop in average highest blood sugar in case of diabetic patients post-COVID as compared to during hospitalization. So from it dropped down from 310 to 234. Whereas among non-diabetics, the drop in average highest blood sugar is less, from 177 to 164 only. And fatigue and severe weakness and muscle pain persists even after discharge in recovering COVID patients. So both these groups had high inflammatory markers during COVID and they had a significant drop post-COVID. So it is also observed in this slide that those patients who were admitted during COVID and who were diabetic, they had more severe inflammatory markers than non-diabetic patients. So non-diabetic population was further classified as new diabetes and non-diabetics, and the comparison was done on different parameters. So 35% of cases were hyperglycemic during and post-COVID. And the incidence of new diabetes is almost 34%. New diabetics who are on currently on treatment, so out of these 34% of new diabetics, 43% are on insulin and 70% are on oral medication. So new diabetics are older to non-diabetics, that is 50 versus 45, with a similar gender split, and 65% of new diabetics have comorbidities pre-COVID. So significantly more proportion of new diabetics, they got hospitalized and they required high flow oxygen support. And they also received higher doses of steroids and antivirals. And this difference is statistically significant with odds ratio of 2.77. So it was really, this is the most important conclusion or inference what we could draw from this particular study. Average blood sugar during COVID among new diabetic patients is 1.6 times more than non-diabetic patients. And new diabetics are experienced slightly more symptoms than COVID. During post-COVID, blood sugar levels and symptoms were compared. And as expected, significantly high blood sugar levels were seen in cases of new diabetics than non-diabetics. But there was no much difference in symptoms. And the average HbA1c, which was found in new onset diabetes, was 6.7%. Whether the HbA1c was 5.8% in non-diabetic patients. So both these groups had high inflammatory markers during COVID and had a significant drop post-COVID. And new diabetics had significantly high inflammatory markers than non-diabetics. So to summarize, this study has three distinct groups emerging from this particular study population. There are diabetics, which are 58%, new diabetics, which are 14%, and non-diabetics, who are 28%. So we tried to compare and do a multivariate analysis, and we tried to find out severity of COVID and the steroid doses these patients received in cases of new diabetes. And we found that new diabetics were the patients who had severe COVID infection, as it was seen on HRCT, and who required high flow oxygen support. They had longer duration of stay in the hospital, and they required higher doses of steroids. So you can see here that in the first column, diabetics, they received 62 milligrams per day strength of steroids. Mean strength of steroid, the dose of steroid was 94 milligrams per day in new COVID group, and it was 54 milligrams per day in non-diabetic groups. So to conclude, significant, that is 34% of number of new onset diabetics in the study population, 65% of these, they have pre-COVID comorbidities. They had more severe disease. They had received higher doses of steroids and vice versa. So it may be like that these patients, they had more comorbidities, so they had more severe disease. Because they had more severe disease, they required higher doses of corticosteroids, and probably that is the reason why they remained hyperglycemic. But it is too early to comment about this. We still need to follow up the same cohort further. And the concluding remarks are, those who had more comorbidities, as I said, they had severe disease, they required high oxygen, longer duration of hospital stay, and so they required higher doses of corticosteroids. And one of the reasons why we can still call them as new diabetics, because they had high HbA1c, and they are still requiring treatment for hyperglycemia at present. And we will need to follow up this cohort further to find out if this is steroid-induced diabetes or it is new-onset diabetes. So it was really interesting to find, because when we all collected data, we all really didn't know. We all were busy in managing these cases, and now we are hit by non-COVID cases. So we just collected this data, and thanks to Medeva, they all analyzed it properly. That's all from this particular study. Now I request one of the participant, Dr. Anuj Maheshwari sir, to join and say something about this study, because it is your brainchild.